happens here, the promises of God.
I used to have the time somebody runs out. Sorry about that. Good morning. Welcome. And hear the promises of God. God is near to all who call from their hearts. The desires of those who fear God are fulfilled, their cries are heard, and they are saved. I am the resurrection and the life. All who believe in me, though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Fear not, I am the first and the last and the living one. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you, I will uphold you with my victorious hand. Blessed are the dead who die in Christ. Blessed indeed, says the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Friends, we gather here in the protective shelter of God's healing love. We are free to pour out our grief, release our anger, face our emptiness, and know that God cares. We gather here as God's people, conscious of others who have died and of the frailty of our own existence on earth. We come to comfort and to support one another in our common loss. We gather to hear God's word of hope, which can drive away our despair and move us to offer God our praise. We gather to commend to God with thanksgiving the life of Pat Valentine as we celebrate the good news of Christ's resurrection. For whether we live or whether we die, we belong to Christ, who is Lord both of the dead and of the living. Patricia Pat Valentine, 84, of Ogallala, passed away Wednesday, June 27, 2018, at Indian Hills Healthcare Community in Ogallala. Patricia was born January 30, 1934, at Oshkosh, Nebraska, to Monty Ray Smith and Cecil Peg Gwendoline Bullery Smith. She attended and graduated school at Oshkosh, Nebraska. From there, she married Laverne Olson, and from this union, they had two daughters and one son. For a while, she lived in Spring Valley, California, and Napa Valley, California, raising her children before coming back to Oshkosh and then Ogallala, Nebraska, where she met the love of her life, Ray Valentine. They were united in marriage June 16, 1989, in Julesburg, Colorado, celebrating 29 years of marriage just recently. Patricia always loved doing crafts of all kinds, decorating her home and cooking for her family and loved ones. She was always well known to her loved ones for sharing her many delightful dishes. Survivors include her husband Ray of Ogallala, two daughters, Marla Peters and Lonnie, and Don Olson of Ogallala, stepchildren Trent Valentine of Texas, Tanya Meyer, Rob of Malmo, Nebraska, Casey Valentine and Renee, Haley Cornelius and Brian, all of Omaha, Nebraska, 12 grandchildren, 5 great-grandchildren, 1 great-great-grandson, 2 brothers, Richard Dick Smith of Loveland, Colorado, and Mike Smith and Beth of Pendleton, Oregon, and many nieces and nephews. She was preceded in death by her parents, Monty and Peg Smith, and her son, Greg Olson, of Scottsdale.
Consider all the worlds thy hand.
Pray. Almighty God, whose will is sovereign and whose mercy is boundless, look upon us in our sorrow and enable us to hear your word. Help us hear so that through the patience and the encouragement of the scriptures, we may hold fast to the assurance of your favor and the hope of life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Savior. Amen. Friends, hear the word of God in the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And the 46th Psalm. God is our strength and refuge, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountain should shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and though the mountains tremble with its tumult. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The God of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. And from Paul's letter to the church at Rome, what then are we to say about these things? If God is for us, who is against us? He who did not withhold his own son, but gave him up for us, will he not with him also give us everything else? Who will bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, yes, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will hardship or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep to be slaughtered. But no, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. And from Paul's second letter to the church at Corinth. So we do not lose heart, though our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this light momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient, but the things that are unseen are eternal. And later in that same letter, yes, we are of good courage, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. And from the Gospel according to Luke. And when they came to the place which is called the Skull, there they crucified Jesus and the criminals, one on the right and one on the left. One of the criminals who were hanged railed at Jesus, saying, "Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we are receiving the due reward of our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." And he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come in your reigning power." And Jesus said to him, "Truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." And finally from the Gospel according to Luke. Now as they went on their way, he entered a certain village where a woman named Martha welcomed him into her home. She had a sister named Mary who sat at the Lord's feet and listened to what he was saying. But Martha was distracted by her many tasks. So she came to him and asked him, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to do all the work by myself? Tell her then to help me." But the Lord answered her, "Martha, Martha, you are worried and distracted by many things. There is need of only one thing. Mary has chosen the better part, which will not be taken away from her." Well, Generous and loving God, we give you thanks for the life of Pat, for the memories that we have for her, and for the sense of your presence here to bring us comfort and peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Good morning. I want to begin by offering my sincerest sympathies and condolences. I have learned a lot about Pat. Ray and I had a really good conversation Thursday or Friday, and I learned a lot about Pat, and some from folks that I've spoken with here this morning. And I must admit, I didn't know her, and I regret that, having now learned so much about her. I learned some things that I really, she reminds me, I told Ray, she reminds me of my grandmother, so I have a sense of fondness for the things I heard about her. And she sounded like a wonderful woman. And so I can imagine the grief that you're all feeling. And so, as I say, I want to begin by offering my condolences, a great loss that you will feel in your life. As I thought about what to say this morning to all of you, it's always kind of hard to share my thoughts with those of you who knew her so well. But I find myself thinking about, as I read, the character of Martha in Scripture. And I will explain to you why that is, but let me share with you a few of the things that you no doubt know and that you will be missing about Pat. As I told Ray, in our faith tradition, a funeral service is actually a service of thanksgiving for her life. And so my task this morning is to help you to give thanks for Pat, as well as helping to comfort you and to remind you that she is with God now. And so we have grief, but we also have joy. So the Pat that you all knew so well, I hear, was a great cook. And loved to cook, and loved to cook for family reunions and family events, and that gave her great joy. She loved her family, and she loved to do things for them, to cook for them. She was a gardener, I hear, and found great joy in that work. And she enjoyed the work that she did outside the home as well. She was a waitress. And she worked at Ben Franklin at the craft store for many, many years. And that craft enjoyment went into her personal life as well. But one of the things I most have learned about Pat was that she knew God, knew Scripture, had been told by several people she could quote the Bible. I'm always a little nervous about doing a service for someone who can quote the Bible, because as anyone who knows me well knows, I'm not a memorizer. And so I'm not one for quoting, and so I get the quotes kind of wrong, and the people who know them really well kind of correct me. I've gotten used to that over the years because I'm not a quoter. So I have great respect and love for people who can quote Scripture and who know the text that well, who know the tradition that well, who love God that well and make the commitment to do that. And so I was impressed to hear that Pat knew Scripture so well. I was also sorry to hear about Pat's illnesses, her many illnesses that she's suffered over the years. But it is some relief to know that she is with God now, and those illnesses are past, and she is happy and at peace. As I thought about what text to bring to you this morning, you may have been surprised at my reading the text about Mary and Martha. Not typically a funeral text. And so I want to go on and read one more text about Martha. You know the story, as I just read it, about Mary and Martha. Martha was busy doing things around the house. And I always worry that Martha gets a kind of a bad rap. She like Pat, like a lot of women, enjoyed doing things for others. She enjoyed serving others. She enjoyed, it appears, she enjoyed cooking and cleaning and doing the things that women have traditionally done, as Pat did. And so I was worried that Martha gets a bad rap for being this kind of, for not sitting at Jesus' feet the way Mary does. And so I want to read to you another text about Martha that I think sums up the ways in which she and Pat are alike. So this is a text from later, this is from the Gospel of John. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had been in the tomb 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away, and many of the Jews who had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went and met him, while Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that God will give you whatever you ask of him." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again on the resurrection in the last day." And Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one coming in the world." So Martha, John kind of redeems Martha here. And so the busy, working, serving Martha who isn't sitting at Jesus' feet in Luke, we find was listening nonetheless and was learning about Jesus and was as convinced as anyone that Jesus was the Christ and that her brother, Lazarus, would come into the world again, would live again with Jesus healing of him, as we know. But she also knows about eternal life, about life after death, about the life that Pat is now enjoying with God. And so Pat did her work in this life. She served her family, she cooked, she gardened, she did her crafts, and Ray was telling me that they have crafts all over their home that she did. So he will have plenty of memories of her. That she had great memories, she had great experiences with her family, her children, her stepchildren, her grandchildren, and that she loved them and was committed to them, as Martha was. And so in many ways, as I thought about Pat and learned about Pat, the image that kept coming to my mind from Scripture was that of Martha. Who knew, in the midst of all her service to others, that Jesus was the Christ and that she had nothing to fear. And the thing I want to remind you, especially Ray, of most certainly, as you've said to me and others, was that Pat was ready. She was ready. She said so. In the midst of all of her illnesses, she was ready to go. She knew that she would be separated from her family for a time, but not forever. And she knew that she would be welcomed into the arms of Christ, as Martha knew. And so I want you to take some great joy in all of the years of service, of cooking, of gardening, of crafts, of love for family that you have with Pat. I also want you to remember that she knew, as Martha did, that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, and that one day she will be with him. And so we give thanks that that day has come for Pat, and we pray your comfort and that of all those who will miss him. And I hope for all of you that these moments that bring you tears today will turn to memories of all of those family reunions and great meals and crafts and gardening and quiet moments that you spent with Pat. So that while you might feel a sense of grief now, one day those memories will simply bring gentle smiles and gratitude that you need. Let us pray. Generous and loving God, we give you thanks for having given Pat as a gift to so many who knew her, and for the fact, the knowledge that we have, that she is now with you. In Jesus' name.
Bye.
Now, I'd like to give you an opportunity to share memories that you may have of Pat. Is there anyone who'd like to stand, either stand where you are or come forward and share your memories of Pat? I know. Yes, please.
Pat was my best friend in Nogal, and we shared Christ a lot. We would always get together and talk about the Lord and the things that he would do in our lives. And I don't know if everybody knew that Pat had a wonderful sense of humor, and we had the best time together. I remember picking her up from church, and I had a Jeep, and she couldn't get in. So she went head first in, and we laughed so hard she couldn't get the rest of her body, race standing there laughing. And so after church, then we, there was icy out. Well, then she couldn't get back in because she kept sliding. So we've laughed about that for years. But we just had such a wonderful time, and we were friends for so many years. But I got to see her. I came down early, because Ray called me, and I got to see her. And so I did my crying then, and I got to be with her, and I got to talk to her before she finally went into where you couldn't talk anymore. And I just thank God for that. She was a wonderful person.
Thank you. Others? Yes?
I had the opportunity to always be spending Christmas Day, or usually, with Pat and her family, and she would always bring wonderful, wonderful desserts. She was famous for making pie, and I'll greatly miss those.
Yes?
I'm Diane Atkins, and Pat worked for me for many years. And besides being such a great employee, she was a very good friend, and she was such a mentor to me with my faith and getting through some hard times, you know. And so that's what I really appreciated most about her, was her sharing of her faith, and she did it in such a gracious way. I mean, she was never hit you over the head with it, you know. And but she was very firm in her faith, and like I said, she was just a wonderful mentor, and I appreciated her so much.
Thank you. Yes.
Pat was my grandma, and whenever I had a problem or I felt like I needed some counseling with maybe understanding things, I always called grandma. She always had just about the perfect thing to say, and I always told her I knew that God gave it to me to help me understand.
Thank you. Sorry for your loss. Others? Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for your word. It is a lamp for our feet, a light for our path. We thank you especially that in the night of our grief and in the shadows of our sorrow, we are not left to ourselves. We have the light of your promises to sustain and comfort us. Through our tears, give us vision to see in faith the consolation you intend for us. In your mercy, grant us the unfailing guidance of your saving word, both in life and in death. God, our strength and our redeemer, giver of life and conqueror of death, we praise you with humble hearts. With faith in your great mercy and wisdom, we entrust Pat to your eternal care. We praise you for your steadfast love for her all the days of her earthly life. And we thank you for all that she was to those who loved her. We thank you that for Pat, all sickness and sorrow are ended, and death itself is past, and that she has entered the home where all your people gather in peace. God of all mercies and all comfort, in tender love and compassion, embrace your sorrowing servant. Be our refuge and strength, and ever-present help in trouble. Show us again the love of Christ, which passes all human understanding. For by death Christ has conquered death, and by rising Christ has opened to all of us the gates of everlasting life. Thanks be to you, O God, through Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Holy God, by your mighty power you gave us life. And in your love you have given us new life in Jesus Christ. We now entrust Pat to your merciful care. We do this in the faith of Christ Jesus, who died and rose again to save us, and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Amen. Holy One, now let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. Our own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in every people, the light to reveal the nations and the glory of your people. Amen. May God bless you and give you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May God look upon you with kindness. May God give you peace. Amen. Quality Inn following the interment. So I am sorry. Sorry, buddy.
Let's just wait till we get out. understand that.
I'm just gonna have some barbecue sandwiches out at Comedy, come out there.
Okay, how do we get back to the interstate, where we need to be at the end of the Casey's?
Is it where we got off on 27, 96, 30, actually?
Yeah, and it's off to the right hand side.
Okay. See you guys there a little bit.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Do you know which ones are hers?
Yeah.
No.
The yellow ones.
Yeah, that's right.
The red ones.
I love that.
Our shelves are over there.
Well, when was she just having this, she said she wanted to make sure that they were what she wanted, so.
Right.
That's nice.
I saw some looks on faces.
You gotta have your telephone too, huh?